$1 return to the city. We want to talk about Mayor Bloomberg's policy of consulting out all of the fraud associated with that. And we want to talk about the non-competitive salaries and the lack of a contract that civil servants have been dealing with for the past 3 years. When you think about all of these issues, this press conference is really about accountability. Accountability to these private consultants and where Bloomberg spends all this money. The beautiful part is we've received $500 million back from SAIC. Yes, the last 5 years we've seen layoffs, service cuts, and high levels of attrition. I can speak from my own agency, in my own position. I'm a criminalist at the Office of the Chief Medical Examiner, and the City Hall has been concerned about the increase in turnaround time in sexual assault kits. That's been directly related to attrition and low staff levels. The mayor keeps justifying these layoffs, these reduced staff levels through attrition because of this tough economy. Oh, this tough economy, I have to make tough choices. But today we stand before you, we have to ask the tough questions. What about all your wasteful spending, Mr. Bloomberg? What about all your city time? Attention must be paid to this issue. Attention must be paid to, the list goes on and on. We have the 9/11 call system. Over $350 million was reported to be wasted through that system. We have the NYCHA CM bill, which associated with that, with the CM bill, are ballooning costs and delayed projects. We have NICAPs. We have Seedco, Bloomberg, the employment contractor that had all this fraud and wasted city taxpayer dollars. We just had a letter that came out recently from the U.S. Congress where 11 congressmen from New York City asked for an investigation to where all this money is going through Bloomberg private consulting. Attention must be paid to this. And then, of course, there's city time. Nearly $500 million returned to us from SAIC. I say we should return it to the very people who suffered, the people who got laid off, the people who didn't receive a contract, the people who don't have a competitive salary. At the OCME, people leave and go to other laboratories because they can get trained here with taxpayers' dollars and then leave and go to Delaware, Maryland, anywhere on the East Coast to get paid significantly more. So when we think about what to use this money for, and when you hear from labor leaders and city council people, ask yourself, do we just want to throw this money back into a general fund to close a gap? Never mind the surplus and the rainy day fund that's sitting there. Why don't we use this money to undo some wrongs that were done? Why don't we use this money to make our salaries competitive, keep intellectual capital in-house, in this city? And let's get rid of this revolving door that we've created in the city. Before I move on, I want to just touch on, John Liu just came out with a report about the income gap in this city. It's growing. The top 1% in the nation account for 16.9% of the wealth. We've all heard this before. In New York City, the top 1%, they account for 32.5%. So that the climate in New York City is different from the rest of the country. Again, back to this $500 million. I say we invest in our workers now, or we're going to pay for it tenfold down the line in the form of a more uneducated society, larger classrooms, a weakened tax base because people are going to leave. And if we don't do something now, we're going to have a more reinforced, divided, racially and economically divided city. So thank you for coming out. Take the opportunity to listen to the labor leaders that are here, listen to the city council people, and get some insight on where this money went, how we got it back, and what we should use it for to set forth a better future for this city. So without further ado,